Okay, let's take a look at the first one. We got open-ended questions, which is 13 to 14 open-ended questions. I'm going to cover each topic. So let's look at the first topic first. So first topic, we got diversity of living and non-living things. This is the very, very first topic that you learn in primary three. Okay, so you have to know the six characteristics of living things, which is need air, food, and water, respond to changes, blah, blah, blah. You can read yourself. I want to cover the fact that when we look at, let's say, an example, this observation. Can you see observation at the example here? Here we got the organism moves from sunlight to darkness. Hey, teacher, I know what is the reason. The reason is that the organism can move by themselves because they move, ma. Okay? But if you write down move by themselves, you'll get a wrong answer. Because why? You look at this. It's from sunlight to darkness. Okay? Sunlight to darkness, there's a change in the environment. And based on this observation, you cannot say move by themselves. Based on this observation, there's a change in the surroundings, so you have to use this one, which is respond to the changes in their surroundings. Many of you know your answers, but the problem is when your answers, you didn't finish up the sentence, which is something we have missing things in your answers. Okay, and that is the underlying portion that I underlined for you. Make sure it's in their surroundings or around them. Same thing for move by themselves. Please do not tell me move from place to place. Okay, so move from place to place is wrong. This is wrong. Because plants, they do not move from place to place. Only animals. Unless the question specifically tell you about animals and then ask you to state about animals, then sure, you can go ahead and write down move from place to place. Okay, but to be safe, always put move by themselves. Plants can move by themselves as well. Just that they don't move from place to place. Okay, next one. We got six animal groups. Make sure you know the six animal groups and the characteristics of each one of them. So example, we got insects, we got amphibians, we got mammals, we got birds, we got fish, we got reptiles. Okay, so I'm going to highlight the ones that many of you might make mistakes in. The rest can read yourself, okay? So first one, we got insects, we got hard outer covering. You can write this if you want. Or you can tell me exoskeleton. Basically, the skeleton is found on the outside. Skeleton. Okay? The skeleton is found on the outside. And that is the reason why it's hard. Okay? And then after that, we got, of course, normal six legs, three body parts. And then for amphibians, make sure you know that they are moist skin and lungs. And then lives both on land and in water. And then the young actually breathe through gills because they live in water majority of the time until they grow to become adults, then they can live both on land and in water. Okay? And then for mammals, same thing. You got outer fur or hairs, outer body covering. They breathe through lungs and give birth to young life. So if I didn't state give birth to young life, the rest are insects, amphibians, birds, fish, reptiles, right? The rest, they all do not give birth to young life. So of course, the opposite will be lays eggs up. This is how they reproduce. Okay, nah? This is the rest. The rest are all laying eggs. Okay? Of course, there are exceptions as well. Like example, your guppies and whatever things. Okay, but majority of the groups that I've stated, majority of it actually lays eggs. Spiders are not considered insects. Spiders have no six legs. Spiders have eight legs. So they are arthropods or something like that. But it's different, not in your syllabus. Okay, so now, these are similarities and differences. Make sure you compare. They love to ask you to compare. Ask you to compare what? The different groups of animals. So how do you compare? You have to compare, example, the breathing example, breathing through moist skin, fishes breathe through gills. Notice I'm comparing the same thing. You cannot just compare outer covering with breathing. It's two different things. I can compare hair and my hand, different things. Okay? I can compare hair with another person's hair. So example, same thing. So make sure you have to know that if I compare, make sure you compare the same thing, whether it is the skin, outer covering, whether it is the breathing, whether it is the living in the water and on land, those kind of things. So make sure it's comparing the same thing. Okay? Lays eggs or give birth to young life. So next one, we have bacteria and fungi. Bacteria and fungi is very special because this one is not the same as your other organisms. Okay, this is another group of organisms. Bacteria and fungi are called decomposers. So again, decomposers, what's the purpose of it? It actually breaks things down into simpler substances. Simpler substances is not the same as smaller pieces. Not the same as smaller pieces. If you want to compare this, smaller pieces is actually from your teeth. You actually break things down using your teeth, right? Example, this is just another comparison for this. So teeth itself breaks things down into smaller pieces, but what breaks things down into simpler substances is like your digestive juices. Your saliva, example. Your saliva is part of your digestive juices, and that is breaking things down into simpler substances. Very similar to my bacteria and fungi. I'll show you a picture later on to show you what is the difference. So of course, you got fungi and you got bacteria. Fungi includes some examples that you should know is your mushroom and mold. Bacteria, you don't have to know some examples. Just know there's bacteria as a whole. But your syllabus, make sure you know the fungi. There's two different commonly tested fungi, which is your mushroom and mold. Okay? And because the reason why they break things down into simpler substances is because it's not because they got nothing to do. They cannot make its own food. It's not a plant, by the way. Not a plant. So even fungi is not a plant. So you can tell me, mushroom is a plant. It's not a plant. Mold is also not a plant. Okay? Because plants can make food on their own, but you realize that fungi and bacteria cannot make food on its own. They cannot photosynthesize. It's not green in color. It has no chlorophyll. So it has to feed on other organisms dead or alive by breaking things down into simpler substances. They feed on them. They go there to eat the food. At the same time, they break it down into simpler substances. Okay? Not because they have nothing to do, they go and eat. They go and like break things down. Okay? They purposely go there because they need the food. And then, how do they actually grow? They grow through having moisture, which is water, oxygen, and warmth. It looks so familiar. That sounds familiar. Very similar to something that we learned, which is our germination. Correct? Very similar to germination. Germination, which is my plants, right? They actually from seed to seedling. And that you also need these conditions, which is your WOW. Wow. The wow here, we are looking at water, oxygen, warmth as my conditions needed for my bacteria and fungi to grow and reproduce. Yes, so for digestive system, please use smaller pieces for teeth, simpler substances for digestive juices, exactly the same. Okay? So teeth only breaks down simpler substances. So let me just show you a very quick picture about moldy bread. As you can see, right, we've got moldy bread. I don't know if you have seen before. Some of you have kept maybe your bread, forgotten about it for a long time in your bag or something. Okay, so what happens is that you have this kind of black bag stuff. Notice it's very different from my ants eating. Let's say I put a piece of bread on top. Then you've got insects coming, got maggots maybe, then got ants and all these, right? You do not produce such color. What happens is that maybe my bread becomes smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller because my ants go and take it away, break it down into more pieces, then you see all the maggots crawling around. Fine. But the point is for fungi and mold, these two, okay? I mean, fungi includes mold. All these is actually breaking things down into simpler substances because they are feeding on it. Clear? Okay, let me go back. So you've got to memorize this one, this part. Cannot make its own food, have to feed on other organisms in your life. Okay? And of course, you must know the conditions required for it to grow. Same as my germination.